Hello everyone! Welcome back to Dr. Zarifa. Today I will tell you about vitamin B12, which is needed for red blood cell formation, neurological function and other important bodily functions. Vitamin B12 is a water-soluble vitamin that is naturally present in some foods and available as a dietary supplement and a prescription medication. Vitamin B12 exists in several forms and contains the mineral cobalt, so compounds with vitamin B12 activity are collectively called cobalamins. Vitamin B12 acts as a cofactor in complex biochemical processes, participating in the synthesis of nearly 100 different substrates, including DNA, RNA, hormones, proteins, and lipids. Vitamin B12 is an important link in the metabolism of fats and proteins. This vitamin is essential for the proper formation of red blood cells. Vitamin B12 bound to protein in food is released by the activity of hydrochloric acid and ferments such as gastric protease in the stomach. Synthetic vitamin B12 is already in free form and thus does not require this separation step. Then free vitamin B12 combines with a special glycoprotein, intrinsic factor secreted by the stomach's cells. Afterward, this complex absorbs in the intestine, but only approximately 56% of 1 microgram oral dose of vitamin B12. The amount of absorbed vitamin B12 will be significantly lower when a person has gastric atrophy resulting from pernicious anemia. If pernicious anemia is left untreated, it causes vitamin B12 deficiency, leading to megaloblastic anemia and neurological disorders, even in the presence of adequate dietary intake of vitamin B12. The functions of vitamin B12 in the human body forms and repairs red blood cells, thus preventing anemia, improves growth and appetite in children, increases energy, supports the nervous system in a healthy state, promotes proper use of fats, carbohydrates, and proteins, reduces irritability, improves concentration, memory, and balance. Vitamin B12 is naturally found in animal products, including fish, meat, poultry, eggs, milk, and milk products. Vitamin B12 is generally not present in plant foods, but fortified breakfast cereals and some nutritional yeast products could contain vitamin B12 with high bioavailability for vegetarians. Vitamin B12 is usually present in dietary supplements as cyanocobalamin, both in oral and sublingual forms. The body's ability to absorb vitamin B12 from dietary supplements is largely limited by the capacity of intrinsic factor. For example, only about 10 micrograms of a 500 micrograms oral supplement is actually absorbed in healthy people. Vitamin B12 can be administered parenterally, usually by intramuscular injection. Parenteral administration is typically used to treat vitamin B12 deficiency caused by pernicious anemia and other conditions that result in vitamin B12 malabsorption and severe vitamin B12 deficiency. For those patients who don't prefer injections, can use a vitamin B12 nasal gel spray formulation. The recommended dietary allowance for men and women ages 14 years and older is 2.4 micrograms daily. For pregnancy and lactation, the amount increases to 2.6 and 2.8 micrograms daily, respectively. A tolerable upper intake level is the maximum daily dose, unlikely to cause adverse side effects in the general population. No upper limit has been set for vitamin B12, as there is no established toxic level. Vitamin B12 status is usually assessed by serum or plasma vitamin B12 levels. Values below about 170 to 250 picograms per milliliter in adults indicate vitamin B12 deficiency. However, evidence suggests that the concentration of vitamin B12 in the blood and within cells can vary greatly. Elevated serum homocysteine levels may also indicate vitamin B12 deficiency. However, this rate is influenced by other factors, such as low vitamin B6 or folate levels. Elevated methylmalonic acid levels are a more reliable indicator of vitamin B12 status, as they indicate metabolic changes that are very specific for vitamin B12 deficiency. Deficiency of vitamin B12 occurs with prolonged strict vegetarian diet, poorly planned food without milk, eggs, meat and fish, in violation of its assimilation in atrophic gastritis, resection of the stomach or intestines, in severe enterocolitis, in worm diseases, broad tapeworm, liver diseases. Relative elementary vitamin deficiency can occur during pregnancy and chronic alcoholism. Interestingly, it may take more than 5 years for sign of vitamin B12 deficiency to appear after the body's reserves are depleted. No case of vitamin B12 toxicity has been reported, even with megadoses. However, some evidence suggests that supplements of 25 micrograms per day or higher may increase the risk of bone fractures. In diseases of the central and peripheral nervous system, neurological diseases with pain syndrome, vitamin B12 is administered in sufficiently high doses, 200-500 micrograms per day. Side effects such as agitation of the nervous system, tachycardia, and urticaria are rare. In patients with angina pectoralis, vitamin B12 should be used with caution in a single dose of no more than 100 micrograms. With simultaneous use of hormonal contraceptives for oral administration and vitamin B12, the concentration of cyanocobalamin in the blood plasma may decrease. Absorption of cyanocobalamin from the intestine may decrease when taken together with anticonvulsants, niacin, aminosalicylic acid, colchicin, cimetidine, ranitidine, potassium preparations. With parenteral administration, chloramphenicol can reduce the hematopoietic effect of cyanocobalamin in anemia. A diet lower in vitamin B1 and higher in folate, such as a vegetarian diet, often masks vitamin B12 deficiency. If you are following a strict vegetarian diet that does not include eggs and dairy products, then you need a vitamin B12 supplement. Vitamin B12 may also be helpful for protein lovers and women during menstruation and premenstrual period. When combined with folic acid, vitamin B12 may be the most effective remedy for restoring vitality. It's worth pointing out that a normally functioning thyroid gland promotes the absorption of vitamin B12, so make sure your thyroid is doing well before taking vitamin B12 supplements. That's it for today. In the next video, I will continue to tell you in detail about vitamins and vitamin-like substances. Subscribe to my channel, ask questions in the comment section, hit likes, I would be very pleased. Thanks for watching. Take care of your body and mind. Bye.